Hey, this is Alex from Make Them Suffer, and you're watching Matthew Scar.
How are you doing?
I'm very happy, actually.
Yeah?
First ever download, first attendance, and first time playing. So,
what can we expect from this set list?
Ooh, we've got lots of hectic energy on stage, and we're playing a bit of a shorter set, which is sick, because it's just go, 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 punch in the face, lots of energy, lots of jumps and kicks and
it's like,
screaming.
Boom, 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 and then thank you, good night.
That's it, and then we're out. You never see us again. Yeah.
And I wanted to ask you also about the latest song, Epitaph.
Yes.
Was it a difficult song to write? Was it an easy song to write? What was the process into making
that one? Sean actually is the creative writing genius in the band. He writes all of the vocals. You know, we sit together and sometimes we'll try and write together, but he doesn't need my help. So he wrote Epitaph. And it's an epic song. Like, even the demo was an epic song. So I think there was lots of pressure to get it right. And I think we were writing that song last time. We were touring America with Parkway Drive.
Okay.
So we were writing it while we were on tour. Or maybe it was Bad Omens. Anyway, so it's seen a few choruses. It's seen a few iterations. But then when he showed me that chorus for Epitaph, I was just like, holy shit, that is so epic. The start, the gang vocals at the start of the song are epic. So I think he nailed it. And then it's really hard for me to sing. It's a really hard chorus to sing. I've had to work pretty hard to execute it live, but we're getting there now.
Yeah, I think you're getting there. Absolutely. I can't wait to hear it.
Yeah.
You've been in the band since October 2022?
That's right.
What's your top three favorite moments?
Oh, I love
so
it.
So far.
Yes. I mean, being in this band is honestly a dream come true. So every moment is kind of like a life-changing moment. But probably we toured America last year with an Australian band as well called Northlane. So we were Parkway Drive and Northlane. We were on that tour and Amity Affliction. It was an all-Australian lineup. We had a day off with Northlane. We went to Salt Lake City in America.
Yep.
We all got a big Airbnb next to the mountains, and we had a big party in this Airbnb in a hot tub. So we were sitting in the hot tub watching the sunset, looking at the mountains with the snow, drinking champagne. And I was like, this is my life, this is my job.
Life is good.
Sorry, Northlane. No one cares that we did that. It was sick. It was sick. I was like, this is like, I'm here with my best friends. We're just partying in a hot tub behind the mountains on tour. So that was one. Another one would have been touring Australia with Bring Me the Horizon, to play in front of Australian crowds. A tour of that scale was just insane. And then probably when I got asked to join the band, Nick was a friend of mine before. I didn't really see it coming. We sat, and I just remember a whole bunch of things had happened before that, but he sat me down at a cafe one night and he asked me to join the band, and it was the most surreal experience because I knew my life was going to change after that. So
yeah, I know it started with something like, let's go for a run.
Right, yeah, during lockdown in Australia, we had a brutal lockdown, especially in Melbourne, so Nick and I lived nearby. It was almost like it was meant to be. We were like literally locked in a 5 kilometer radius with each other, and we were hanging out and running, sort of both talking about our different experiences with our, I was in a previous band at the time, and when he asked me if I wanted to have a coffee, I knew he was going to ask me to join the band. And it was sort of like, you know, when someone asks you on a date or something and you're like, oh my God, I'm so nervous, I can't.
Yeah.
And I was kind of like, I knew it was going to happen. Every moment's been incredible, but those are three standouts.
Yeah, it worked out pretty well.
It did work out, I hope so, yeah.
Also, what's on the horizon for the band? What's this summer looks like?
Well, we're about to. So once we played Download, we're going across Europe and playing some more festivals, which is amazing because I've actually never done Euro Summer. So it's my first time here in the sunshine and it's not cold, which is really nice. We're playing with some sick bands, some side shows. We're playing with Bury Tomorrow, playing with While She Sleeps, Silverstein, so that's sick. And then we go back to Australia and we're headlining our own tour in Australia, bringing the new music that we haven't played live yet back to those Australian audiences, and maybe a few more surprises. So I'm the legend.
Trying to stay busy.
Yeah, we're very, very busy. There's no rest for us for a very long time.
Okay, I asked this question to Sean as well in November. Can you describe each member of the band with one word?
Sean. One word's too hard because they'll think I'm insulting them, and I'm not. I love every single member of this band. Sean will go mastermind. Nick is Galaxy. He'll understand that. J-Man is Feet. He'll understand that. Jaya, Energy.
Okay.
A little bit cryptic.
Fair enough. They will understand,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah, they'll understand. J-Man will laugh at his.
What's your favorite song to play live at the moment?
Favorite song to play live is definitely Ghost of Me. It's just so fun. We open most of our sets with Ghost of Me, and it's just a banger. Like, it's just, like, high energy. Everyone reacts to it really well. It gets the set going. It's awesome back and forth vocals and really fun to play. So,
would you say is the right song to introduce the band to someone new?
That's a really tough question because there's so many chapters of the band. But I think that would be a great start for sure. If you don't like that song, well, you're not going to like Make Them Suffer, maybe. So yeah.
Fair enough. What's the weirdest source of inspiration you came across so far?
The weirdest source of inspiration.
When it's about writing. And,
that's,
you know,
a tough question. I don't even know how to answer that. Maybe just turning, it's not even weird though, just turning anything negative into inspiration. Like any bad, difficult situation on tour, like, yeah. Get it, mate? That's a tough question, I don't know. I don't know how to answer that one, yeah.
Okay, something unexpected, something that you don't expect.
Maybe a really good example of that would be the fact that in Australia during the pandemic we were locked down,
yep,
and we weren't allowed to leave our houses for more than an hour a day in Melbourne in particular. And from that whole experience the new chapter of Make Them Suffer was born, and the band, like the new band, was created in the way that it is now, and the friendship between Nick and I. And I feel like a global pandemic that almost ruined all of our career, took away our ability to write, took away our ability to perform, broke up friendships, and honestly almost ruined all of our lives, was the reason that we're here now. So that's probably, you know, nothing's ever bad.
Yeah,
nothing's ever bad.
Sometimes it takes a bit more time, it takes a
exactly.
little bit of...
Things always unfold, yeah.
Not giving up, basically.
Exactly, yeah.
Favorite non-metal bands?
Favorite non-metal band? I love Muse. I don't know if you've ever heard of Muse.
Yeah,
yes, yes, yes. What they are, probably my all-time favorite band. And they're like just eclectic rock. I don't know, but they're, yeah, definitely Muse.
Something that you really regret buying?
Something that I really regret buying? So many things. I wish I just had all my money. No regrets.
No regrets.
Okay. I don't have regrets. Everything's a lesson.
Also, what would you do if you were not a musician?
If I was not a musician, if you follow me on Instagram, I'm obsessed with CrossFit and sport. I love sport, gym, CrossFit. So I would be a CrossFit athlete. Yeah.
Okay.
I always think that's if something ever happened, if I lost my voice or something happened, I would just straight into CrossFit.
Living in the gym.
Yeah,
24/7.
Pretty much. Yeah, pretty much it. Yeah.
I'm more into like martial arts, but
That's still awesome. Still. Yeah.
Do you have any useless talent?
Useless talent? I don't. I don't have any party tricks.
Okay.
I think no. No, I don't have a good answer for that one. Yeah.
Okay.
Anything? Do you have any?
I don't know. I don't think so.
No.
Do I have any?
No talent.
No, I have no talent at all.
Well, I think a useless talent is I can do lots and lots of pull-ups. I can do like 11 pull-ups in a row, which is...
That's not useless.
It's pretty stupid, but I feel really accomplished that I can do that.
That's not useless.
Probably just that. I can do lots of chin-ups and pull-ups.
Anything you want to add?
No, thank you for having us. And just thank you for everyone that supports Make Them Suffer and we get to be here, which is unreal.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.